Mitch Gallagher, welcome to Sweetwater's Guitars and Gear. This time out, Don Carr and myself check out the new PRS John Mayer signature guitar. Let's get started. Checking out the Silver Sky. Now this is the latest signature model from PRS that was designed for John Mayer. It's based on his 63-64 vintage guitar, has a lot of attention to detail. It's a great sounding, great playing instrument. So Don, we've had a chance to sit down and play with this guitar, and obviously the elephant in the room is that it's based on a vintage 63-64 guitar.
Yeah, exactly. And what are you going to do? I mean, that's what John wanted, right? I mean, it's a signature guitar for an artist, and he's going to get what he wants, which is great. He should.
Right, absolutely. You know, it's so interesting to me that so many companies have done their take on the vintage single-coil guitar, and you know, everyone just accepts it. When PRS does it, there's a big uproar. It's kind of interesting to me.
Yeah, it is kind of funny. Well, you know, that's social media, right?
Right, you know, and there's some kind of polarizing factors there.
Yeah, of course.
Right, I mean, it's PRS, and it's John Mayer, and they can have a polarizing influence on some things, but I'll tell you what, man, from what I can tell, this is an amazing instrument. I spent a few days with it. I know you did as well.
Yeah, I did. I had it in the studio a couple of days and just had it in my office messing around with it. And really feels good just right out of the box, man. Just a player's guitar, definitely.
Right. And there's some firsts here for PRS.
Mm-hmm.
This is a 25.5-inch scale length.
Right.
It's got three single-coil pickups that are based on, again, those vintage single-coil designs. And some interesting appointments as well. Let's take a quick tour. The body of the guitar is finished in PRS's traditional acrylic urethane finish, and it's an alder wood body, so it resonates nicely. It's very lightweight. We also have an extra scoop here that you don't have on the vintage instrument, and that's a very slightly different color. The instrument comes in four different colors. This is tungsten. You can also get it in onyx, frost, and horizon. The neck shape is based on John's 63 vintage instrument, and it's called the 635JM. It's a comfortable, larger C shape, has a rosewood fingerboard, maple neck, and it's actually finished in a lacquer finish, so you get the feel of playing a vintage guitar, and it'll wear in nicely as you play it. We have narrower and slightly shorter frets than you'd find on a traditional PRS instrument, and they're again more like a vintage instrument. The headstock is basically an inverted PRS headstock, but it's been reshaped slightly so you can really bring your hand up here, so if you're doing tight chords down at the bottom of the neck, there's plenty of room for your hand to get down here and grab hold. Truss rod adjust is here at the nut, so you don't have to remove the neck from the body to adjust the relief in the neck. To help keep things in tune, we have a locking tuner, but it's a more of a vintage design than you see on other PRS models. And an interesting little side note is these are actually steel shafts, whereas on most PRSs they're brass. We've got a bone nut, which gives you great sustain and ping out of the tone, and it's actually set into the neck using hide glue, so it's very easy to replace the nut or to adjust it if you need to. Working our way down the guitar, we have 22 frets, which of course you wouldn't see on a vintage instrument, but it does give you that high D. And with the cutaway and the extra scoop in the cutaway, it's very easy to access that highest note. We have three single coil pickups that again are based on John's vintage guitar. These are called the 635JM. Now it's the same pickup in each of the positions. There's a consistency there as you move from the bridge to the middle to the neck pickup. And we have a five position switch, which gives us all the combinations. Bridge, middle, neck by themselves, and then bridge and middle, and neck and middle together, and they're noise canceling in those last two positions. The bridge features Paul's steel plate design, and it has the knife edge in it, which makes it very smooth. But unlike other PRSs, we have bent steel bridge pieces, and that gives us nice ping and nice top end out of the guitar. The controls include a master volume control, the middle tone control controls the middle and neck pickups, and the bottom tone control controls the bridge pickup. PRS has redesigned the knobs, as well as the knob on the switch, and that makes for very comfortable adjustment of the controls. As the guitar ships, the bridge is pulled down tight against the body for maximum resonance, and of course you can adjust that. We have ours floating here just a little bit, because that's the way both Don and I enjoy playing the guitar. every detail on the guitar has been addressed, from the shape of the neck heel to give you maximum access, to actually the shape of the jack, which makes it very easy to get a plug in and out. Wrapping things up, we have the strap buttons, which are the traditional PRS design. And I don't know if you knew this or not, but a little known fact, they're actually based on the string tree from a bass guitar. So Don, one of the things that stood out for me is that this is really a player's guitar. You know, if you'd get a vintage instrument or even a new instrument like this, you typically would make some changes to it, you'd make some adjustments, but in my case, I took it out of the case and it sounded great right out of the box.
I know, I completely agree. And the other thing that was amazing to me was that when I read the specs on the neck shape, I thought, maybe not so much for me, but man, it's so comfortable. It really is.
Yeah, I had the same response when I saw that the curvature on the fingerboard is actually a 7.5-inch right. radius, which is rounder than I typically play. Yeah. Typically, I'll play a 9-inch or 12-inch. But in this case, it feels great, and you can play, you can bend way up on the neck, and it never frets out.
Right, never frets out at all. And the action is very reasonable. It's not like the action's way jacked up to make that happen.
Right, right. I found the same thing with the frets. Typically, this is a smaller fret than I would play, right. but no problem at all.
I know. It feels great. It still feels completely natural under my hands. It's an easy transition to play.
Right. Now, I know that you have a guitar like this that you play a lot in the studio. Mm-hmm. Tell me about your impressions of the pickups.
Man, super balanced. The neck is really nice and throaty. The bridge is bright without being squawky or honky or, you know, and again, like you'd said before, the balance between the three is just really smooth.
Right. There's not that harshness on the top end. It really is never strident, even when you're cranking up the high end, whether you're in a clean amp or whether you're adding some dirt. It stays smooth and it stays warm. There's good articulation.
Absolutely.
I'm also impressed with the sustain of the guitar.
Yeah.
It really rings nicely. And of course, you know that I'm very much into the resonance of the woods and everything as it's playing, but you can really feel this guitar vibrate.
Yeah, you sure can. And a big part of that too goes along with little stuff that goes farther down the line, like intonation and just balance between strings and balance between registers of the guitar. Just, you know, that's a big part of it, man.
One of the things we've talked about before when we've looked at signature instruments is sometimes they're so specific to that artist that it's difficult to get other sounds out of it. I don't think that's the case here.
No, I don't either. I mean, this is just an instrument that you can just pick up and start playing immediately.
Right, no matter what style, really. Yeah, it covers a lot of different things. John, they really did think of every little detail when they were working on this instrument. I mean, it truly is a player's guitar.
Yeah, and kudos to John and Paul Reed Smith, really, for getting down to every fine little detail, even the tremolo arm, for crying out loud. I mean, it's your standard PRS pop-in tremolo, which I love anyway, but this has got a tension adjustment on it, so the bar can swing if you want it to when you let go of it, or it'll stay in place wherever you want it to stay.
Yeah, they thought of everything, didn't they?
Yeah, they sure did.
I hope you've enjoyed this look at the Silver Sky John Mayer signature guitar from PRS. It's an incredible instrument that can cover pretty much any style, super versatile, and we had a lot of fun checking it out. Don, thanks for sitting down with us today and discussing the guitar. It's been a lot of fun.
Yeah, thank you, Mitch. It certainly was.
And thank you for joining me for Sweetwater's Guitars and Gear. Be sure to tune in next time. We'll have more guitars, more amps, more effects. We'll be making lots of music. I'm Mitch Gallagher. We'll be right back.